Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Daria Willis, president at Howard Community College, and thank you for joining me for this episode of Pathways. Today, I'm in the Hospitality and Culinary Suite, and I'm gonna learn about all the yummy goodness that's happening in this area and what you can do to register and enroll in this program. So if you're ready, follow me inside, and I can't wait for you to see what I'm gonna learn. Hey, Professor Banks.
Hi, Dr. Willis, how are you?
I am well, how are you?
Good. Welcome to the Center for Hospitality and Culinary Studies.
Thanks for having me, because I've been looking forward to learning all about what you all are doing here.
Sure, we do a lot of things down here in the center.
Okay.
We've got baking, culinary, and hospitality.
Okay, so tell me, what's the size of the program? I mean, how many students do you have at any given time at the beginning of the year?
Sure, we average anywhere from 150 to 175 students.
Wow.
Some full-time, but most part-time.
Wow.
They take a variety of classes. So we do intro to hospitality.
Okay.
Intro to baking and pastry. We've got culinary basics that we take students through.
Okay.
So we start with the foundations first, then we build on that, and then we end with a externship or an internship for students to have an opportunity to get some real life work experience.
Awesome. So with your background, which I hear is pretty steep in some really good organizations like HEB, one of my favorite grocery stores, but tell me, why is culinary training so important?
Culinary training is so important because it gives you a skill set that is marketable, where you could easily get a job in a restaurant, starting as a dishwasher or a prep cook, and work your way up.
Mm-hmm.
But that's going to take you some time to get there.
Mm-hmm.
What education does is it fast tracks you through that process.
Okay.
So you're going in with the skill set of management, understanding how to read the numbers, what that looks like, how to write the schedule, how to set pars, how to order, a multitude of things that give you a leg up to someone who hasn't had that training.
That is awesome. So are you teaching any entrepreneurial or business skills along with cooking or pastry or just hospitality? Like, what
is
that like?
Yes, we do. Our students that are enrolled in the degree program do get to take a variety of classes, such as accounting, intro to business.
Okay.
They can take these classes in tandem with their culinary and core classes so that they have a well-rounded experience.
Okay.
We want them to take one of three paths. We want them to either go on to transfer to further their education, or they can go and become entrepreneurs and do their own startup, or they can look at corporate restaurants and operations that are already existing, production-style kitchens where they could go in and play an integral role in managing on that side as well.
Very good. So about how long does it take? If I'm a student and let's say I want to do one of our certificate programs or the associate's degree, what's the minimum amount of time that it'll take and the max?
The minimum commitment is at least a year.
Okay.
To get a certificate, you can stay for 2 years and get the degree. A lot of students take a little longer when they come part-time, but we try to make that schedule as flexible as possible to meet the students' needs to make sure that they're having opportunities to take care of their side of life as well as school. So often they're working or raising families, doing a number of things while going to school. And we like to get them into the certificate first so they can get that skill set and start working in the industry and then continue to build out their degree.
And then as I take it, and I've learned just in my time in community colleges, that when our students leave our institutions, they stay right here in the community. So have you seen a lot of our students who have been in our culinary and hospitality programs just out and about within Howard County or in Baltimore, showing off the skills that they learned here?
Yes. I'm always surprised when I walk into a restaurant or a store and I run into one of our students. I'm like, look at you, doing the job, doing the work.
That's the best part, isn't it?
Getting it done. That's the absolute best part. And they always radiate what they've experienced. They talk about everything they've learned in the classroom that they're actually using on that job. So
That's
great to see that connection.
So everything comes full circle from the classroom when you see that light bulb go off to them finishing their certificate or degree to out into the community making a difference.
Yep, and that's what it's all about.
Good deal.
Staying around here and getting the work done. We've got a lot of new concepts in the area that students are working in. Graduates are doing their own thing. So we're proud to see our students come through the program.
So I'm ready to see what this is all about. I've heard about all the hype since I've gotten here to HCC about the hospitality and culinary program. So where are we off to
first?
Well,
I'm here to show you the hype. Let's head over to the bakery first and we'll see what they got going on.
You lead the way.
You got it. This is Vanessa Carballo and Chef David Milburn, Dr. Daria Willis, and you guys are gonna do a demo.
Awesome, thank you so much. Hey everybody, it's good to see you.
Hi.
So Vanessa and Chef Milburn, I hear great things about our bakery and pastry program. What are we doing today?
So today, you and Vanessa are gonna finish these tarts.
Okay.
So we have a chocolate caramel tart. So it's a chocolate crémeux with a caramel, pâté sucré crust. We're gonna finish it with raspberries and chocolate beads, so.
Ooh, so yeah. Vanessa, question for you. Do you like chocolate?
I love chocolate.
Oh my gosh, yes, chocolate is the great equalizer, is
of
it
course.
Not? Absolutely. Yeah. So tell me more about what students learn in the program.
Sure, so with our program at HCC, a student can get a certificate or a degree in baking and pastries. Their first class in the lab would be baking and pastries, which is covers all the basics.
Okay.
From there, they're gonna go into the advanced pastry kitchen, which you're in right now.
Okay.
Our brand new kitchen.
Looks pretty advanced to me.
Yeah, yeah, it's awesome kitchen. And state of the art, definitely. And here, they're gonna take advanced pastry techniques, artisan breads, cake decorating, candy making, show pieces where I teach them how to sculpt in chocolate and sugar. They're also going to take a quantity bake shop production.
Okay.
And then we also have coming in the spring or in summer is our Passport to Pastries, our study abroad program.
Oh, cool.
So I'll be taking students to France.
Oh my God, where can I sign up?
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be fun.
After all that, I need to be part of this program. Yeah. So in the advanced class, they learn how to make wonderful cakes that we see and different events like weddings and birthdays and things of that nature and pastries and such, right?
Oh yeah, definitely. Okay. In our cake decorating class, their last project is each student has to make a wedding cake.
Oh my gosh.
So they're getting a lot of experience here.
Okay. Well, I've already gotten married, but maybe I can, I can get my vows renewed so I can get me a cake. So Vanessa, what has been your experience in the program?
It has been a very wonderful experience. I've made a lot of new friends in this kind of controlled chaos environment. I mean, you never know what's going to happen in the kitchen, but following the recipe and just taking it one step at a time, despite all the moving parts, has been a very fun experience.
So I know that we're in like an empty kitchen right now, but when you talk about controlled chaos, I just imagine everyone trying to get their cake flour and the measurements right and a lot of talking and interactions. Is that what it is?
Oh yeah, it's a lot of collaborative work. I mean, you see one thing and you have to come ask someone else, it's like, can I take this off your table so that I can use it real quick? And you have to share a lot of stuff.
Okay.
So it's a lot of asking and seeing if it's okay.
So there's a lot of teamwork.
Oh yes,
a lot of teamwork in the kitchen. Yeah, definitely.
And it prepares you for going out and doing your own thing and working in teams.
Indeed.
Awesome. So let's work in a team today.
Okay.
And I hear that I'm going to get to make one of these yummy tarts.
Of course.
So I have some gloves for you.
Okay. Okay. I haven't done this. So.
It's okay.
Here we go. Okay, I don't get to do this on my day job, so I'm really excited about putting on gloves and decorating a chocolate tart and learning from you, Vanessa. So what's first?
So first, we're going to place our raspberries.
Okay.
So we usually try and do five at a time because everything looks best in odd numbers. So if you want to start by just grabbing some and putting them in each corner, like so. Reach around you and do it again. And just keep going on all the corners.
I just have to follow everything that you're doing, so I'm gonna
be a
little slow with it.
No, it's okay.
I can't even make a cookie.
And then I'm gonna...
I'm telling you, my kids will be like, oh my God, what is she doing?
Okay. And then we're gonna take some chocolate pearls, and we're just gonna place them, just like a little pinch at a time. Just place them around just to kind of fill the space.
So when we develop this tart, we're looking at all the different textures. So we want contrasting textures.
Okay.
And we also want contrasting but complementary flavors happening.
Okay.
So we have the tart shell, nice and crispy. We have the chocolate crémeux, nice and creamy. We have the caramel, we have the raspberry, we have the chocolate beads, all different textures. Then we have the different contrasting flavors. We have the vanilla crust, the chocolate, the caramel, the raspberry, all comes together.
So it's just like a party in your mouth,
exactly.
Right? Once you take the first bite. Oh my gosh, this is lovely.
And then we just put this
back
to the side.
Okay.
And look, you've done a beautiful tart.
Can y'all see my tart? Tell my kids I did this, okay? Wonderful.
And then now we're gonna place it on there to get ready to take it over.
Because we're gonna sell these, right?
Yeah.
So both of them?
No, just one.
Just the one.
Oh, and then
even presentation. Like to even and center it so that it looks nice for the customer.
Beautiful.
And now we're ready to go and put them in the display case.
Okay. Oh, I thought that would be heavy. Okay, I can do this.
Okay, all right, now let's go.
I'm following you, Vanessa.
Watch your feet.
Okay.
Okay, ready to bring our beautiful pastry goods here. Mm-hmm. So you want me to just lay it into the case
just come
here?
Right into the case.
Okay, and I gotta be careful with the case, right?
Perfect.
Vanessa, do they look good for presentation?
Of course they do.
Okay, of course I like that.
Yeah, so we're looking for like tiny little tin soldiers, everything all lined up, nice and perfect.
Looks good.
Yeah, definitely.
Ready to sell to the customer.
Yes, we're ready to go.
Well, thank you all so much for showing me how to like make my first bakery item without burning it or anything of that nature, and they look yummy. I've learned so much from you about the program, so can't wait to learn more from Hal next.
Thank you for spending some time in our kitchen today.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right.
So, Dr. Willis, can I introduce you to Professor Hal Kinney?
What a pleasure to meet you,
hey,
Dr.
Perfect.
Willis.
And Hal is going to tell you all about our hospitality program.
Okay. Right. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you. Bye.
Well, Professor Kinney, so I've been to the bakery side, and now I'm looking at hospitality and what we're doing in this space. So tell me more about the hospitality program.
We couldn't be prouder of the program. Besides being blessed with the wonderful facilities that that we have, the program consists of of an AAS degree, an associate's degree in the hotel hospitality event management. But we also have two certificates, one in hotel and one in restaurant. So now students have an option to either do a certificate or even the associates.
Well, that is cool because I travel a lot, as you know, and I'm sure
Big
you
industry.
Do as well. What is the industry for? Because every time I travel, I make a stop in a hotel, and usually I get there around 5 or 6, and I don't have time to go out and find something to eat. So it's really good to have a hotel that has a nice kitchen and restaurant service. And now that after COVID, well, I don't know if we're after COVID, but somewhere near that, what does the industry demand now that things are coming back to a new normal?
That's a great question. You know, I think a lot of emphasis is going to be on health, a lot more healthy options, but also people want a lot more bang for the buck. And the general public these days are also very well versed with food, so they're savvy. So they can appreciate and are also requesting quality.
Yes, sir.
So quality and the best bang for the buck. That's a huge
and healthier
demand.
Options.
Healthier options. And we in hospitality, we have to be able to accommodate allergies, requests, etc. Because they're really becoming a more aware. There's a more awareness about them. So we have to be accommodating and sympathetic to those as well.
So then I'm sure that having to teach students about the different components that you mentioned, there's probably a method to your madness when you think about the structure of the class.
Yeah.
So how is a class structured so you can get students to understand dealing with allergies and everyone's palate and their appetite and what they're looking for?
Yeah, education, awareness. You know, you mentioned something interesting is one of the classes I teach for the introduction to hospitality, and I'm sure several people have heard this before, but I feel that's one of the most important classes where I need to not only inject the love and passion of hospitality, but also educate and establish an awareness of just how broad a spectrum it is. It's not just waiting tables. It's not just cooking of meals. It's, as you mentioned, travel, tourism, attractions, park, casino, catering, food and beverage. It's just such a wide spectrum. And I don't know if people are exactly as aware as they should be. with another particular class where we've collaborated with culinary. And now the students are collaborating together and creating a concept or theme for a particular menu that we would serve live to the public, to the school public. So that's an incredible program,
And then one more question, and I know this one's probably off script a little bit, but when you talk about the hospitality feature, I just know that as more and more Americans are, we're working all the time and we're looking for that moment of relaxation. Like these folks and what you're doing with our students, to me, is equally as important as what we're seeing in like our health sciences, where they're going out and saving lives and in the hospitals and such. But in a certain way, you're helping people prolong their life by welcoming them to a nice atmosphere, smiling when they come in, because you never know what baggage they're coming into when they're walking into your hotel or into your restaurant and their flight's been delayed. And I can tell you about my flight story later.
Yes.
I mean, what do you think about that? I mean, it's just, to me, all the services that we offer and what we teach is about transforming lives and helping people in the community just feel better about themselves. I mean, what do you think about that?
You know, one of the things I teach is the difference between hospitality and service. Service are the basic steps. You go through the motions, and there are, you know, I teach 10 steps of service. However, in hospitality, we provide the experience.
Yeah.
And to me, if someone comes into an establishment, I want them to feel like they're at home. And I mean, we in hospitality, it's 24/7, 365.
Right.
So we spend a lot of time at our business. So it's our second home. And so when we welcome guests, we want them to have a sort of escape from the real world and experience. And I call it the bookend effect, from the from when they enter with a being welcomed with a warm smile to the very end when they say, thank you so much for coming. Come back and see us
and
again.
And they're like crying because they're leaving because they had such a wonderful experience with you.
It's so memorable that the fact is that each person that has a great experience is likely to tell 10 people.
Okay.
So there's that branch effect.
Yeah.
10 people tell 10. And
Word of mouth.
Yes. And that's the key, is delivering a quality, consistent service so that you get repeat business.
Beautiful. So how long does it take a student to complete this program?
It's a two-year program.
Okay.
The associate's 62 credits, but however, the certificates are only 22, 23 credits.
And they're stackable, so if I come in and do a certificate for 20-ish credits and I decide I want to come back and finish it up, then I could just stack that and continue on?
Absolutely.
Beautiful.
They do carry over. Yeah.
Beautiful. So yeah. What are we going to do here? I hear we're making something yummy.
Yes, we're going to make a cappuccino with froth on top, a little sprinkle of something, something. So yeah, let me show you.
Let's do it.
Over here. Actually, I'm going to bring in Kim, can you come on in? Let me introduce you to Dr. Willis.
Hi, Kim.
Kim is going to demonstrate that for you.
Nice to
meet
you.
She is the professional at cappuccino making, which is an art. So please, Kim.
Okay. Be happy to.
And so I'm going to be able to have this cappuccino with some of those yummy desserts, right?
You know, perfect combination.
I love it. So what are we doing, Kim?
So this is fresh ground coffee beans. We've grounded it into powder, of course.
Okay.
Did we press it? And now I'm going to brew. Just take a second.
Is this like what they do at Starbucks?
Yes.
Oh, this is state-of-the-art.
State-of-the-art? Like the Nespresso machines and
Yes. This is a professional.
So now I need to froth the milk and make a little noise. But
can I look?
Yes, sure.
So when you say froth the milk, what do you like?
So we're warming it and also almost doubling in size.
Okay.
To just get that foamy top.
Oh.
So you see how it's,
Okay. See, I would have wasted it a long time ago.
Top it. Okay, and a little bit of cocoa on the top. Hope you enjoy.
beautiful. Thank you, Kim.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Can I try it?
Sure.
All right, so do I do this with my pinky up?
You can.
Any which way you like.
Let's see. Excellent job.
Thank you so much.
Better than Star Wars.
Thank you so much, Kim.
Thank you, Professor.
Appreciate it.
Awesome.
So, Dr. Willis, let me show you what's going on in the culinary kitchen lab.
Okay.
The students are cooking up something. Come on.
Nice. I get to eat too?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Come on in, Dr. Willis.
All right.
Let me introduce you. This is Ariana Gonzalez.
Hi, Ariana.
Hi.
It's so good to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Wonderful. So I've learned a lot about this operation here, but tell me what's happening on the line today.
So on the line, we are operating with recipes according to the menu. Mm-hmm. Currently, we have a sandwich making station and a salad making station with our own vinaigrette. And currently, I'm also plating the salmon croquettes that we made just a little bit ago.
Wonderful. Well, the salad looks fresh and yummy, and the sandwiches. So tell me more about what's happening with the salmon croquettes.
So with the salmon croquettes, what we pride ourselves here at Dragon's Fire Lab is staying to the theory acronym BUFF, which stands for Balance, Uniformity, Flow, and Focal Point.
Wonderful. So balance, uniformity, flow, and focal point.
Correct.
Okay. Thanks. See, I learned something. Do I get a full 3 credits for this class today? No? I need to learn a little bit more?
No, but you actually are able to place the last croquette if you like.
Yes. Thank you. If I mess up, what happens? No, I'm just kidding. Okay.
Don't worry. I'm here for you.
So I put it here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right, perfect.
Well, look at that. A wonderful display of BUFF right here on the line. Thank you all for making such yummy dishes. And I set it here at the top for the server to come next.
Ready to order.
Awesome. Well, I have learned a lot thanks to my good friend Ariana Gonzalez and wonderful staff here in the kitchen. Thank you for joining me on this edition of Pathways, where we've learned a lot about our hospitality and culinary programs. And if you want to learn more, check out the HCC website. We need you to register after you check out the website, get enrolled, and we need your butts in the seats come the next semester. Thank you, and we'll see you soon.